morning. In the previous class, previous lecture, we completed the Langevin theory of dynamicism, and in this class we are starting Langevin theory for the paramagnetism. So this Langevin theory of dynamicism, which we already studied in the previous class, it is the most important topic according to exam point of view. And this in this lecture we are going to perform Langevin theory of paramagnetism. This is also most important according to exam. So let's understand carefully. Okay, so for that, let us consider a bulk sample in which the very large number of paramagnetic atoms contains. Okay, and in that paramagnetic atoms, the dipole moment, okay, the dipole moment with normally oriented random in the direction. So that's why, so that the net magnetic moment of the sample as a whole becomes zero. Okay, we already know that the characteristics of paramagnetic material, which we discussed in the first class also, the dipole moment of the paramagnetic material becomes zero. Okay, so that's why the dipole moment of all the sample, dipole moment of the sample becomes zero. So this is the characteristic. Okay, so when such material, so when such sample is placed in the external magnetic field, so an atomic moment of, or the atomic dipole of magnetic moment, that is denoted by the letter Pm bar. Atomic dipole of magnetic moment. Atomic dipole of magnetic moment written as the Pm, and this is the vector, so that's why Pm bar. Okay, Pm vector Pm. So this is the atomic dipole of magnetic moment Pm, lying in the direction of, where such sample is placed in the direction of external magnetic field. So this Pm lying in the directions making an angle theta with the direction of magnetic field, and this will tends itself, align itself in the direction of the magnetic field B. That means, so this is the diagram we are showing here. So this is the direction of magnetic field. Okay. And here the two cones making an angle theta with the, so this is the direction of B. This is the first cone making angle theta, and there is another angle made by these two, and this angle is the d theta angle. That means here write down Baha. So this angle is the d theta. So d theta is the small angle, and this theta is the greater angle. So this Pm, this vector Pm, that is atomic dipole of magnetic moment, will tend itself making angle theta with the direction of this field, magnetic field B, making angle theta. Okay, so therefore the magnitude of corresponding tall Q, the magnitude of corresponding tall Q is equal to Pm B sine theta. Okay, so this is the magnitude of corresponding torque Q, Pm B sine theta. So if an external force, if we apply an external force, that is by the action of external force, this so due to the external force, it displaces the angle d theta. It displaces to the angle d theta in the direction of the field, so making angle new angle d theta with the B. Okay, so this force is nothing but the work done. Okay, we apply a force, and this force is nothing but the work done. Therefore, the work done by the force, the work done by the force in displacing this theta to d theta. So this work done by the force is equal to Pm b sin theta and making angle d theta. So therefore we write here d theta means force into displacement, that is the work done. So this is the torque, is nothing but the force Pm b sin theta, okay, and this d theta is the displacement, that is force into distance, displacement, it is the work done, Pm b sin theta. So hence the total work done, in displacing the atomic dipole to the angle to the position making angle theta, we know that already the angle is the theta. So hence the total work done in displacing the atomic dipole to the position making angle theta with the direction of this B, magnetic field B. So this total work done, in displacing the atomic dipole to the position making an angle theta is equal to integration 0 to making angle theta, that is the 0 to theta, and work done is the Pm b sin theta into d theta. So if we integrate this term, we get the new term, that is the integration of sin, that is the minus Pm b cos theta. So this is the total work done, and we already know that this work done is always stored in the form of potential energy, that is the potential energy of the atomic dipole. So therefore potential energy of atomic dipole, that is U, is equals to minus Pm b cos theta. These all are in the magnitude form, so that's why we write here only Pm b cos theta, okay, and is the negative sign. So if we consider, so next, so this is the first number equation, U is equals to potential energy of atomic dipole, U is equals to minus Pm b cos theta. This is the first number equation. So if we consider, a spherical volume having a very large number of atomic dipoles, if we consider a specific form of volume, and in that volume there this volume contains a large number of atomic dipoles, and the number of those and those atomic dipoles, okay, the number of those atomic dipole possessing the potential energy U is equals to minus Pm b cos theta, means the atomic dipole present in the volume contains energy Pm b cos theta minus let's forget minus sign. So potential energy of the atomic dipole containing in the volume, spherical volume, that is the Pm b cos theta. So this number of atomic dipole is directly proportional to the solid angle enclosed between the two cones. So this is the angles theta, and this is the theta plus d theta. If we miss this theta and d theta plus d theta, so this number of atomic dipole contains an energy Pm b cos theta is directly proportional to the solid angles enclosed between the two cones theta and theta plus d theta, that is within a solid angle, twice pi sin theta into d theta. So that if we consider dn is the number of atomic dipoles and this dn is directly proportional to the solid angle, that is the twice pi sine theta into d theta. Okay, this is the first concept. So this number of atom in dipole contains an energy, potential energy PMV cos theta is directly proportional to the solid angles between the two cones, that is the semi-vertical angles theta and mixed angle theta plus d theta. Okay, so this directly proportional, that is twice pi sine theta into d theta. So this is the second number equation. Okay, so the tendency of the atomic dipoles, the tendency of atomic dipoles to align themselves in the direction of magnetic field, this tendency of atomic dipoles to align in the direction of magnetic field B is opposed by the thermal agitation. That means thermal agitation is nothing but the temperature increases. Okay, so due to the temperature increases, this tendency is opposed. So hence the probability that an atomic dipole will tends in the position making angle theta and theta plus d theta, this proportionality, okay, so this probability is nothing but the, this probability is, according to the law, this probability is the probability to align the atomic dipole in the direction of magnetic field B is e to the power u by kt. Here k is the Boltzmann constant, T is the absolute temperature, and this u is the potential energy, that is PMV cos theta. Okay, so this u e to the power u by kt is the probability that, probability to align the atomic dipole in the direction of magnetic field is u to the power, here we are taking, because this is the minus, u is the minus, here minus, minus u by kt. So this dn is also, so this dn is also proportional to the u by minus kt. Okay, this probability is also proportional to the number of atomic dipoles, means when the probability increases, the number of atomic dipoles align in the direction of magnetic field is also increases, that is dn is directly proportional to u by kt. This is the second number equation. So finally, third number equation. So finally, we can write this dn is mixedly proportional to minus u by kt into twice pi sine theta into d theta. Okay, so if we remove this proportional sign, we get dn is equals to c e to the power u by kt into twice pi sine theta into d theta. This is the fourth number equation. Okay, so this is the small part of this equation. So we continue here up to the next, in the next class. Okay, thank you.